It's Leo, BNC Network, chilling, going up to the Seattle City Breakers reunion. Got a lot of cats already showing up. This is pretty exciting. And coming in limos and shit. Got Lee coming up. But yeah, so hope you enjoy the footage. We're coming through, represent Seattle and its roots. So we look forward to the footage. What up, Lee?
What up to the world? I'm excited. This is the 20-year reunion right here.
Nice, nice.
Rafael Contreras, originally from San Diego, California, and live in Seattle now. And I used to break dance with First Degree Breakers, broke dance with Seattle City Breakers too. You know, I mean, I jumped cruise to cruise every now and again, help out the bros, and you know, when it was a contest and they want to pick me up and they say, let's go against these other guys, I was always, you know, jumping in with other crews and stuff. We did it down in Seattle Center. Used to go to McDonald's right there on 2nd Avenue, hang out there, throw the cardboard out there. And there was no cell phones. There was no way of contacting either. There was no internet, no Facebook. But we just knew. You go downtown, there's going to be crew, we're going to be battling there. And we walk over to the Seattle Center or catch the bus. And right there, just crews, just going against each other all night long. We go from place to place and just do it all the time. You know, we did a lot of contests and you know, it was just cool time. And you know, I like it how all coming back now, and it's good. I like it a lot.
It was exploding. Everybody was breaking. Everybody and their grandmothers were breaking. In fact, I think it blew up so fast that that's why within 2-3 years it just died really quick. And I think what had a lot to do with the breakdancing dying back in the early 80s was the movement of gangster rap, like NWA came out and Eazy-E, and everyone went from, you know, breaker to, you know, shooter. So I think it just took away from breakdancing. But it's back, it's stronger than ever. In fact, it actually came back in the 90s, but what happened was it stayed underground for so long. And you had your competitions every 1 month, 2 months, whatever. Back in our day, it was every 6 months if we were lucky for prize money. Mm-hmm. But now it seems like it's every other week someone's having a competition. So right now it's exploding. It's here to stay, for one thing. It's like not back in the day. There's nothing going to stop it from happening now.
Yeah, I'm Keep One. I used to be called C3 back in the day. It started about 1982. It was more, you got up just because.
Okay.
It was almost a lovely thing. Everybody wanted to do what they wanted to do. It was more free. It was never organized. What's cool about it? There was no sparking. There was nobody was fighting. Yeah, and it shows the younger generation too that I guess you can have a peaceful event with the hardest thugs up in the place too. Some of these old dudes had beef back then. There's no beef now. But like again too. What's cool about this thing, which is somewhat, but there was no love really for the graffiti writers. of the old days. I just knew a lot of breakers.
B-Boy Rambo representing Bellevue, Crisis Crew.
Yo, what's up? This is B-Boy Tone Rock, Battle Reflex Crew, representing Seattle, worldwide. Started breakdancing in about 1996. You know, going to this event, it really opens my eyes and let me know, you know, that Seattle does got a deep root of culture, you know, and it's really hype, it's really uplifting. You know, this is an epic event for me because, you know, seeing this type of shit go down just makes me super happy that, you know, we're gonna keep it live, keep it real. You know, all these kids are gonna see it and they're gonna do the same. And, you know, Nasty Nez was saying earlier, they're gonna be doing this 30 years from now. Boom, we're doing this 30 years from now, you know? Keeping it real. Thank you.
Man, I'm like overwhelmed. I don't even know who's who. I'm like, I just see a lot of OGs, man. Much respect to like the whole scene doing it back in the 90s, 80s to now, man. You know what I'm saying? Much respect.
I go by Specs One, Specs Wizard, from Seattle, Washington. Huh? It's good to see everybody, really. I'm just happy to see everybody together. I've been telling, I've been meeting kids along the way throughout the years because I never stopped doing it. And I always tell stories about all these cats. And they always think I'm kind of making it up or something. So it's good to see all the kids. Obviously, Seattle does have hip-hop history.
Hey, what's up? I'm DJ Nasty Nez. I'm the guy that started the first hip-hop rap show on K-Fox, 1250 K-Fox, and I was at KCMU, Cube 93, all in the mix from 1980 to 1988. My show ended in 1988 because the new owners of K-Fox didn't want me to play rap anymore, so I got fired. That was like the worst day of my life, man. I'd never been fired in my life until I went to K-Fox, and then I took my show to 90.3 FM KCMU with my partner Shockmaster Glenn Boyd, and man, that was like one of my best memories is being on there. And then after that, you know, I started the first mix show on Cube 93 called Hot Mix. I don't think they do it anymore, but at the time it was really big. Everybody used to tune in Saturday nights to listen to me on Cube. You know, I used to be on the turntables.
Are you still living in Seattle?
No, actually, I live in Sherman Oaks, California.
Okay.
And I just came back home here just to be at this 20-year reunion breakdancing event and to see all my old friends and family. And
the streets back in the 80s, beginning of 80, 81, I mean, they were crazy. We was running around the streets, running from gangs, trying to fight everywhere. But once breaking, you know, blew up from New York, man, we just, you know, it brought us all together. And like Carlos and I were talking about, you know, everybody was like, racial, like, you know, blacks with blacks, and, you know, Chicanos with Chicanos. But once everybody started, then it became one big melting pot of mix. That's the greatest love of all, because it's all, hip-hop is all one religion. And, you know, it makes peace with everybody, especially from the streets. I myself actually lived on the streets back when I was considered the best in the world, or one of the best in the world. I was living downtown Seattle, sleeping under space needles and stuff, or wherever my friends would help me and stuff like that. So, you know, when it comes to, you know, street dancing, that's where we are. Yeah, I left for Hawaii around 89, 90, and my mom, she still lives over there, and she's doing good, and she's so excited about this whole event. They thought that I had passed away, but, you know, when Carlos contacted me, he was blown away, and then news spread like a wildfire and stuff. I never stopped. People thought, you know, I took it, you know, hung up the shoes and, you know, didn't stop doing it, but I popped out like a phantom in all the kind of contests and stuff. So that was the best part, you know. I was a fan. I'd jump in, win that show, and jump right out. So we would do maneuvers kind of like one-to-one, and the combos wasn't there yet, right? So I was the main guy, started all these combos after, you know, my older brothers, Carlos, you know, and Junior showed me the power stuff. And I said, I'm going to take this to another level, start raising the beat a little bit and hooking all the combos together. And then from there, all the creativeness that we would think of stuff, you know, like I have a few, I'll let it out of it. Let the cat out of the bag. A few of my maneuvers is taking off the jacket, doing helicopter windmill. And I started the Matrix slow-mo windmill first of all. That was an icy windmill. And a lot of them, just creativeness, but the combos is the key.
Okay.
I got to give a shout out to all my brothers in here, David Toledo, David Pablo, Carlos, you know, Junior LaFell. Everybody helped put this together. Specs, you know, they're all legends, a huge list. And of course, all those that passed. Thank you. Ziggy Z out.
And it was really thanks to Mixlot that he said, Ness, you're from Seattle, 206. And if you notice, all his rhymes, he talks about Seattle. And because of him, I always talk about Seattle. And now, I'm so proud to be from Seattle, 206, right?